Tales of troubled love, forbidden love, and racial turmoil. The Nadine Gordimer stories, dramas of South Africa.
For my daughter in Zimbabwe.
A present.
For my birthday last Friday. Express, 2 days late.
It was your birthday.
Of course, why do you think you got cream cake?
You never told us.
I never do, since I turned 40. Oh, it's beautiful. Look, they send you the cottons along and then you do it yourself.
Embroidery.
He knows me like an open book.
When is she coming to see you?
I must write her a letter. That's the one thing I can't stand to do. There's never anything to tell.
Dear Jelly, Joburg calling. With a big thank you for your birthday greetings and the beautiful cloth. At last, a free moment to start a letter to you. I'll add a little each day and send it to you when it's ready.
Listen, send somebody quickly if you can't go up to the cafe. I'm starving. I'd like a toasted cheese, 2 cook sisters. 3, one for you if you go, and a strawberry milk.
I can't, there's some problems here. I'll send Simeon.
What problems?
That man. I fill him up, top up his oil, pump up his tires. Gives him money from Zimbabwe.
But at least he hasn't driven away.
I've got his keys. He wants to talk to you.
Okay. Fine. Send him in then. Toasted cheese, cook sisters, and strawberry milk. I'm dying.
Here are the keys. It's 28 round 60. Flowers.
Roses.
Now look, sorry about this, miss. My name's Ricky Lopesha, by the way. What's yours?
Phyllis Borman.
How do you do, Miss Borman?
Mrs. Borman.
Oh, yes, sorry.
Well, I don't quite know about this money. I don't know what to do. You've placed me in a very difficult position, Mr. Lopesha.
Yeah, I know. I'm sorry.
Haven't you got any South African money?
No. You see, I've just driven down from up north and I just wasn't thinking. Look, best I can do is this. If I give you this, then you can just keep it till I get you the money. It's a good watch. And I'll go and cash check and I'll get the money to you in, say, honestly, in, say, an hour. This friend of mine will cash check for me.
There's a bank just around the corner, just next to the Bioscope.
No, trust me, I promise you it's a good watch. But I've got to see my friend, I've got to tell him I'm back. Excuse me, I'm just zonked. I mean, like, half asleep, you know?
Okay, I don't quite know what to do. Maybe I should phone Mr. D, my boss. I mean, how could I? We don't ask people to see their money before we... God. Give me the watch. But you promise, huh? 1 hour.
You can time me on it.
Don't worry, I will. Which part are you from originally?
Rhodesia. Zimbabwe.
Oh, I've got a daughter there.
Uh-huh.
Which part?
Well, Salisbury, Bulawayo, Mtali, Whitebridge, Katuma, Victoria Falls, Kariba, I mean, you name it.
Oh, I couldn't. All I know about is Salisbury because my daughter lives there.
Uh-huh.
And Zimbabwe, the ruins. I look at it every day. She sent me a postcard, which is on my mantelpiece.
Yeah, I've been there too, but to me it's just a pile of stones, you know. Look, I better go.
You promise, huh? 1 hour. Please.
Promise, thanks.
Hello? Hello, yes? Who? Mpanza. No, there's no Mpanza here. What? Well, why didn't you say so in the first place? Jack, yes, we have a Jack here. Call him by his name. And you mustn't phone here. The boss doesn't like it at all. No, no, wait. I'll call him. Wait! Jack!
All right, I'm coming.
I just shouted at Mike.
I'm sorry, I told them they mustn't.
Well, this is the last time. You don't understand, it's not just me. There's going to be such trouble with Mr. D.
Well, obvious. Jim, mahalo, Jim. How's it going, Mr. I'm going to go.
Ducky is not here.
Don't you know what we see? Katara Zele, man, you put no check. What if Shushuka Kuruba wants to be sitting in Panza?
If you want to talk to them, why don't you go and phone them from a tiki box in your own lunch hour?
If all black and yeah, in an anicorn, what if 300 rand? Come in with discount on 50 rand. They go on, he's almost six. I'm going late.
So. Mustn't make a fool of me when I'm doing you a favor. I won't take calls for you anymore, you'll see.
No, Mrs. Bowman, you don't understand. He just asked what my name must be, and I said, Jack.
Well, it is Jack, that's true. Why must you people always have 101 names? Why can't your aunties and your uncles and your brothers-in-law phone you and call you by your name directly so that I don't have to waste my time?
No, you see, I'm Jack here because, yeah, Mpanza Makiwane is not a name. And there I'm Mpanza Makiwane because, to my people, Jack is not a name. But you know what? I'm a clever one. Because I'm the only man who knows who I am, wherever I am.
You are too clever for your own good. Yeah, have one of these.
Thank you. Hey, boy. Is this his watch?
Yes.
Rubbish.
Oh my God. I don't know what I'm doing here. Not necessary, really. I don't drink and it's nearly dark.
What are you drinking?
Amstel and lemonade, shandy.
Two Bloody Marys, please.
No, never. Can't stand the thought. Look, it's dark outside now.
Is a place like this expensive?
I don't know.
don't think so.
Tell you, Joburg doesn't exactly turn me on.
It's also the weather. Wait till it rains.
People here owe me. I'm collecting and moving on. Who's that bloody waiter? Tell the wogs here something else, eh?
Times are certainly changing. I warned you. 3 days ago I wrote that today is as boring as yesterday and the others are just as bad. Friday I went to the cinema as usual with Mrs. Roberts, a Clint Eastwood film. There was just too much fighting for my liking.
Harry, how can you eat it like that? Is it nice?
Yes, ma'am. You must try it.
Never. I'll end up as fat as a pig.
That man came again.
What man?
The man from the other day.
What man from what day?
The one with the wrong money.
You mean the Rhodesian?
Yes, that one. First he tries to pay with money that's worth nothing. Then with a watch that's worth one ring.
Auntie!
He came and looked in here.
Didn't he buy petrol?
No, so he'll come back later.
Did he ask for me?
No.
So why are you telling me this?
You can't come from Zimbabwe in those tires.
What do you mean?
Did you look at the tires?
Oh, please.
You couldn't drive so far on those tires. They're too worn out. Finished.
Smooth. Maybe they got smooth in the drive.
Never.
But he did come from Zimbabwe. He had that money. Ah, listen, Jack, it's not your business and it's not my business. Okay? Horace Harper's Motors. Oh, hello, Mr. Labron. So, how's Joburg treating you?
Not so good. A bit bad luck. The place I was staying at had somebody else booked from today. I was supposed to go to my friend's place in Berea, but now his wife's brother's moved in with two cousins. What's so funny? Now, I've seen one or two places, but if I had a bloody dog, I'd be ashamed to leave it there, man. What's so funny?
Shame. Two cousins.
It's true. They're always cousins.
The Impala's quite a nice place.
But that's where I was.
Hey, listen, I know of a place. Not fabulous, but it's clean, and the woman who runs it is a very nice person. She's a friend of mine, Mrs. Roberts. The Grand Hotel.
Hey, won't you ask for me? I don't know, either I'm just too ugly or I'm just damn unlucky. I mean, they take one look at me and suddenly they're full.
Okay, it's right near where I live.
You're going home now?
Mm-hmm.
Or can I give you a lift? Oh, please. All my clothes in the car, man.
All right.
How much say this is?
6 rand, single.
Take it.
Okay. Thanks, Alfred. The boss will come downstairs to sign. It's really wonderful value. Faye really keeps a very nice place.
What's her name again?
Faye. Faye Roberts. You see there? There's a Warden Court where I live. It's almost opposite you.
Uh-huh.
I'm on the second floor. There's my balcony with the plants on it.
Oh, yeah.
I'm 27.
Hey, I must come visit you.
When you're nicely settled down.
Okay. Tomorrow after work.
Fine. I'll expect you. Sundowners.
Hello, Faye. Sorry to phone so late.
Yes,
hello. I just wanted to check. Is everything all right with Mr. Lopeshire? The man I brought in yesterday. Oh, that's nice. I don't really know him. He's just been coming to the garage and he seemed rather lost.
Went out a while.
Oh, well, that's nice.
But he asked for your address.
Did you give it to him?
Well, I thought he was your friend.
Oh, yes, it's fine. He hasn't been here yet. Anyhow, as long as everything's okay. Bye. Oh, Phineas. Did anyone call you for me when I was at the cafe? A young boss?
No, Mrs.
Thank you.
Mrs. Bowman, some people asking for you.
Who?
God and the young people. They said they're looking for a boss.
Mr. D?
No, I think someone else.
So why are they asking for me?
I don't know. I think you must speak to them yourself.
All right. Can I help you?
We told the boy it's okay. Waiting for Tony. She didn't meet us here.
Tony? There's no Tony here.
Tony Buerta?
No, he doesn't work here.
Yeah, we know he doesn't work here. He said he'd meet us here. He knows you. Told us how you look and everything.
Buerta?
Yeah, he's got a black Mercedes.
You mean Mr. Lopeshire?
No, Buerta. Tony Buerta.
Yeah, tell him we're here, eh? Maybe we'll come back.
Harper delivery?
God, you gave me a fright.
Yeah, I'm good at that.
I wouldn't be so proud.
See what I used to do to my granny.
I'd hate to. Oh, yes. Some people came to the garage to look for you. They asked for Tony. Is that your friend?
That's okay. I saw them. It looks nice, eh?
My week's groceries.
Uh-huh.
How's the hotel?
Oh, it's fine. Except I don't let you cook.
What have you got in there?
Curry and bread.
You see? But that's what the petrol boys eat.
It's a lot and it's filling.
It smells terrible.
Tastes good.
I couldn't stand it. Listen, why don't you come and eat with me?
Now? Uh-huh. No, I can't. I'm still trying to get my money.
Okay. Tomorrow then, supper.
Okay.
This is where I live. At Warden Court, number 27. Come around 7-ish.
Okay.
What do you like?
Food.
The date then. 7 o'clock.
Okay.
I'm thinking of changing my job. My boss, Mr. D, a Jewish man, pops in once a day. Otherwise, I'm stuck with the petrol boys and even worse, the ducktails in the workshop. Jack! I must inquire at Stutterford's. There's a nice branch nearby. Maybe I'll make a marvelous glove salesman. What do you say?
Yes, Mrs. Bowman.
Listen, it's not a playground out there.
I was waiting for you to finish your letter. I have an invoice for you, handelsman. Very urgent.
But why didn't you say so in the first place? Honestly, Jack. Look at the time. You know I've got people coming for supper. Got a bus to catch. How's the hotel?
It's okay.
She's a very nice person. Very kind.
It's all right.
How old are you?
37.
Oh, you can't be.
How old are you?
That's not a gentleman's question.
42.
Oh, liar.
47.
Ooh, that hurts.
Mm-hmm. You asked for it.
You know who you remind me of?
Oh, don't tell me.
William Holden.
William Holden?
If you were 37, you'd know. He was in a film called Picnic. He played the stranger who came to town and drove everybody mad. The women.
Am I driving you mad?
Don't flatter yourself. You just look like him. A little. Except when you smile.
Have some bread.
Take some fruit salad.
My arm's buggered.
It's nice, Pawpaw.
Yeah, okay.
That's my daughter over there on the mantelpiece with her two little sons. She's the one from Zimbabwe. They're twins. Identical. She sent me this dress. I was waiting to see if you'd notice.
What?
It's from Zimbabwe.
Looks a bit like a nightie.
No, it just needs a belt. Have you got a tape recorder? She sent me a cassette of them talking, but I haven't played it yet.
Ruins, eh? Pile of stones.
Yes, the whole family went there last Easter.
Don't know what I did to it. Got any wintergreen?
Wait, I think I've got some deep heat. It's really very good.
Can I lie here? Double bed, eh? Sexy. Come on, have a heart. How can I reach, man? Hey, it's cold, man.
You alone a lot?
Yes.
Doesn't it make you lonely?
No.
You're still so young. You've got such a lovely skin. To waste on a man. It's like silk. Your hair, too. Such a waste.
What?
It's so thick.
Okay, now about my shoulder blades. Scratched there.
What's this?
Stick grenade. Okay, now low by my kidneys.
And this?
Cuts. from Kane Trade School.
My God.
Now, come on now. Lower.
You know, I come from the Cape, and I was always a bit out of place here. And so when my husband died, and I had to give up the house, Julie kept writing to me, Ma, come to Salisbury. Come to Salisbury. And I kept saying, next month. Next month. But in my heart, I knew I wouldn't go. She doesn't ask me anymore. Sometimes it gets very quiet. I'm sitting there reading, sewing, Radio 5 going, and I think, just say, I can't work anymore, and nobody ever comes. Just say I'm lying there listening to Radio 5 on a Monday, and something happens, and nobody comes, and nobody knows anything, and not until I don't turn up on a Sunday at the Versfelds. Somebody smells something and the radio's still going. Newspapers are full of it.
What?
Women dead. Alone.
You're talking shit.
Couldn't resist that. It's so, so smooth, lovely. And these are so sore, so sore. Just a baby. Boy.
You talk too much.
Thank you.
My pants are getting creased.
What do you do?
I kill. I said my pants are getting creased. Boots.
Rick? Rick?
What?
I'm sorry. I've got to go to work. I'm late already.
Eh?
I want to lock up.
No, I'll lock up, man.
Well, listen, I don't just like to...
You'll lock up everything.
No, just the latch.
Okay, just the latch then.
Rick?
Oh, no, man.
All right, then. You won't forget?
Mickey.
I must go. I'm late. Absolutely nothing to report except feeling a little strange. Exactly why, don't ask. 1 minute I'm laughing and then suddenly I want to burst into tears at everything I hear. Maybe it's my age. You're still here?
Surprise.
No. I saw your car downstairs.
Clever.
Funny. I was just thinking about you. What kind of work would you like to do? I could ask around. Lots of people come to the garage. Oh, I know you don't like that sort of thing. Motor mechanics. Not my style either. But there are always salesmen coming in and customers. All sorts. Joburg wouldn't be such a bad place if you had a job.
Look, I told you to shut up about jobs. I'm not here looking for jobs. They owe me money. Come to get more money out of
it. What money?
This isn't a city, it's a nest of stinking sharks. But I'll get them before they get me.
What's the gun for?
Just don't get carried away, eh?
I'm so scared of them. My father used to shoot. Hunting was his hobby. And fishing. My late husband had a revolver. I know everybody needs one, but... if I had to get hold of one, it would end up exploding in my pocket or something.
Okay, now. Just a second. I'm trying to do something here. No, just keep quiet.
Sorry.
Silence is golden. Scared of guns, eh? How many men do you think this has killed?
You lie.
Yes.
What work do you do?
Yes.
Butcher. Well, you said detective.
to come.
A policeman?
Never.
Thank God. Fidelity.
Still Luke.
Oh, I don't know. Were you teasing me? A soldier? Are you a soldier?
What?
You're not a soldier.
I said you are.
You're a soldier. What is it? A soldier of fortune. A mercenary.
Give me a kiss.
Don't you have to go back to the hotel?
I left the hotel.
Since when?
Last night.
Did you tell Mrs. Roberts?
She knows by now.
You didn't pay her.
Look, I told you those bastards still owe me my money.
My God. Oh, God. I'll have to pay her.
Fool, man.
She's my friend.
That's your problem, eh?
Where are you going to stay? You should never point a gun. Rick, there are those people again.
Which people?
That came looking for you.
Hey, foot sack, man.
Hey, Tony, you bastard. Where was you last night? You know how long we waited, us?
Lie.
Yeah, Pinky said you better leave her alone, else he's gonna murder you.
Ah, fuck Pinky, man.
He wouldn't mind us.
Hey.
Stop it. Just stop it.
You're okay. See you, eh?
Oh, when?
Tonight.
Bullshit!
Would you tell these people you live here?
He's walking up and down. You're all in black. Your face is painted. You move like a shadow. You watch how he paces, how he moves, how he listens, how he waits. You're waiting for your moment. You get up behind him. In your hand is your knife. Gerber Mark One. You ready for anything? Then you're up. Your legs round his waist. He can't move his arms. Your hands across his mouth and nose. He can't breathe. Then stuck. His jugular's open and he's down. Then suck. Slice across his windpipe. Won't make a sound. There. And there. It's all over. There. There. Mm-hmm.
You want a sandwich or some mousses? Dara's going to the cafe.
No, I'm not hungry.
Are you sick?
You remember my friend, Mrs. Roberts?
Roberts?
She came here once with a man in a yellow Toyota.
Mrs. Roberts?
She gave me some narchis from Tsanin.
Oh, yes.
Well, she runs a hotel, like I work here. People are funny. That man from Zimbabwe, he was looking for a place to stay, so I took him there. It's a very nice place. He took the room and he stayed there. And then he went off without paying. Why are people like that? No, really. What's the use of helping anybody?
In Johannesburg, there are a lot of people like that. When I see those people, I know them. Even if they have nice faces.
Do you think he has a nice face?
Yes, but I know him.
That young boss who comes to visit me, you know, did you see him go out today?
I never saw him.
Do you know his car, the black one?
Yes, the big one.
How long has it been gone for?
I never saw it, Mrs.
God, it gave me a fright. Where's the car?
I'm going to Durban tomorrow.
Durban?
No, so I'm having it overhauled. Come here. Now, why are you so upset? People come, people go. I mean, you have to push on sometime. Come here.
Now, stop it. Why didn't you bring the car into us? I would have got a good deal for you. You need retreads, too.
Look, it's no problem. My friend's got a workshop. He's doing it for nothing.
Is that the one who cashes your checks? I thought you were cross with him. Doesn't he owe you money?
Come stretch my back.
No, I feel like having a bath.
Cane in the kitchen for you and for me.
Not for me.
Why are you so upset? I'll be back. Hey, have you got R4?
What for?
I'll pay you back.
You owe me 8.
3. Paid you 5 on Monday. You're right. Have you got 4?
I haven't got it. I've got 2 bloody rands and 55 bloody cents. Here, man, count.
You gonna keep it?
And what about me?
Borrow from my old lady upstairs.
For me or for you?
Look, have I ever not paid you back?
Yes, I'm not so sure. I don't know what to believe about you anymore.
It's for my car. I told you it's getting serviced.
I thought that was for free.
Oh, look, man, stick your fucking help, man. You work with too many fucking Jews.
Well, take it. I don't care. I'm not going anywhere. Just leave me my bus fare.
I need 5.
You said 4.
Hey, wait, look, I'm going to... Hey, wait, man, I want to wash up.
Use the sink.
Hey, you know,
One day, you're going to drown in there and nobody will know. And Radio 5 will just play on and on.
What? Out of my life! Bastard! Out! Get out! Get out! 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 Out!
Trying to get rid of me.
Oh, God.
What's the matter?
I thought you were going.
Where?
Durban.
Oh, no, I'm not going.
Where's the car, then?
Don't worry about the car. I haven't got it anymore.
You sell it?
Jack, you know about cars, what they should cost and so on.
What kind?
Yeah. Utina, 78 model.
What kind?
2.5 big six.
How much?
3,200. And the Datsun 1200, 75 model in excellent condition.
How much?
2,250. And the 66 Mercedes?
those tires. No one will pay much. Yes, Mrs. Bowman.
Jack, can you go or send someone to the chemist? Back at the restaurant.
Are you sick?
Oh, I don't know. I'm just so tired. My head aches.
When my father was old, I worked for him. My children grow up, they must work for me. Why don't you live in Zimbabwe with your daughter?
I don't know. Maybe I don't like trouble.
But even before the trouble, you didn't go. And she must come here. The child must look after the mother. Why must you live here alone in this town?
Listen, Jack. I want you to do something for me. If ever one day I don't come to work, and I don't phone, my friend, the lady from the hotel, the one with the notches, she doesn't phone. And my other friend, the old woman from upstairs. If one day I don't come to work and nobody says why, and I want you to give this address to Mr. D or to Boss George. And tell them to go there and look for me. Finished. Look.
Hey, now that's beautiful.
And it's a record. Any messages?
He was here.
Who?
He said he went to your flat last night and you went there. He said the flat looks different. I told him you were gone. You don't work here anymore. You went to Zimbabwe to your daughter. I don't know which place.
Yes, my love. This life is strange for no reason. Sometimes I feel quite happy. Go to a farm or the park or visiting, and things are fine. And then sometimes I just feel depressed and see Johannesburg for what it is. How can I explain? Sometimes I feel so quiet and still scared. Almost as if I was afraid that I had a murderer and he was trying to find me. I suppose it's no joke. A woman on her own has got to look out. It's not only because of the blacks. This whole town is full of people you can't trust. Still, one good thing, though. Remember the tablecloth and cottons you sent me? I started it the day after it arrived and finished it today. In 16 days. How's that for a record? Maybe I'm in the wrong business.
Short Stories presents Christopher Lloyd in The Penny Elf and